I'm very honored and pleased to announce Professor Avijgan from Isfahan University of Medical Sciences in Iran. He will give us a talk or a workshop on a very interesting topic. It's also, yesterday we had several talks about herbal medicine. I think this talk will be more focused on meridians or acupuncture, so we are very happy and we look forward to your presentation. The title of the presentation is Triple Burner or San Jiao as a Real or False Base of Body. So we look forward to your presentation. Thank you very much.
Okay, to save time, I start my speech. Hi, everybody. I'm more than happy to be here. And thank you. First of all, because this is a purely discussion about a significant concept of acupuncture and traditional Chinese medicine, I mean San Jiao or Triple Burner. May I have the number of people who work in acupuncture? Because I wouldn't like that my workshop be boring for audience. Just two. okay. So it is a workshop that has been arranged for 1 hour, but because really I wouldn't like to be boring for audience, I will present it in short time. But after my discussion, I will give you my PowerPoint, and I'm in your service to be discussed with other about San Jiao. In cooperation with my assistant and also my daughter, Mahtab, I will present this workshop as San Jiao as a real space of human body. Everybody who works in acupuncture field knows that San Jiao is a significant part of TCM concepts, and there is a different idea in the Nanjing school and Meijing school. So that Nanjing say that San Jiao has name but no form, and Meijing school say that San Jiao have both name and forms. And from ancient time in TCM, there is always this difference in idea that San Jiao is in a real space or it's a imaginary space. I would like to invite my colleague Mahtab to present a short introduction about my workshop, and I will continue after.
Hello, everybody, and good morning. Welcome to our workshop, and we are happy to be here with you. Before everything, I have to thank Majid, the organizer of this workshop. The idea of workshop title refers to one year ago. I mean, the main content of this workshop includes San Jiao, a space which is very famous in traditional Chinese medicine. Our team, I mean my residents and internships and I, are working on San Jiao for 2 to 3 years, which is discussed in our in all the TCM ancient textbooks, for example, the Yellow Emperor, Nanjing, Neijing, and some others. In addition, we had personal communication with Machuchia, a famous acupuncturist in the world, and also by research and study in ancient textbook of TCM succeeded to obtain an idea about the San Jiao. Due to the fact that our team is working on the integrative medicine subjects, which includes TCM and Iranian Traditional Medicine, ITM. So in this idea, we could find a similarity of San Jiao in TCM and Meraque in ITM. Final outcome of our study is presented in a book which is under publishing under the name of Invisible Parts of Human Body, from San Jiao space in TCM to Qalaz vessels or Meraque in ITM. This book is publishing soon in two languages, Persian and English. We will discuss more about the content and chapters of this book at the end of the workshop if we have time. In this room, there are surely some people who work in the field of acupuncture and TCM, and some other people who are working in the field of Yunani medicine. I would like to say that Yunani medicine is originated from... Okay. Because there is no one in this room working in Yunani medicine, I would just skip this part. Okay, now let me stop the introduction about San Jiao and Meraque and go straight to the workshop. First of all, we will present several cases by signs and symptoms and then ask you about your diagnosis. If we have enough time, we can have a practical discussion. Otherwise, you can keep your diagnosis in your mind and compare it with us. And then we will explain the reason for point selection and have a brief discussion about any case. And in the end of our workshop, we will discuss the signs and symptoms of patient based on the new idea of San Jiao and Meraque in the workshop as the real space in the human body. After finishing the workshop presentation, I will talk about publishing book furthermore, and if you would like to know more about how to get it, you can ask us after the workshop. At the end of this 1 hour time that we have, we let the workshop has a 10-minute group discussion. We hope to promote a new horizon in your mind about the San Jiao and Meraque, which for complete concepts, you can go to our book.
3 years ago, we have published our first paper in the International Journal of Integrative Medicine as the can the primovascular system or bone conduct be a basic concept for chi production. In this paper, we published our primary idea about the primovascular system as the basic concepts of qi production in human body. PVS is a new primitive circulatory system that regulates embryo developmental process composed of duct, subductal, corpuscle, and granules called sanal in Korean name, sanal. These sanals contain one chromosome. In other words, during sanalization process, each human cell transforms to 46 sanals, and these sanals are circulate in the bone conduct system or PVS. They are originally the source of primovascular system, then transform to pluripotent stem cell, then to very small embryonic-like stem cell, then epiblast germ layer stem cells, and finally in a newborn into the adult stem cells. PVS and these cells can control differentiation of ectoderm, mesoderm, and endoderm. At present, there is unknown role for pluripotent body. Pluripotent body is one of the first cells that can be originated from the first division of zygotes, and after 17 to 24 hours after fertilization, the pluripotent body disappears. In our opinion and in our theory, pluripotent body can be the source or can be the origin of PVS in human body, in embryonic. This idea has been gotten from the animal study that you can see in this picture, that in a hen's egg, there is some you can see here a network that in imaginary picture there is periods, and this is in this part. Periods is a real network in hen's egg, and in our opinion it must be in human embryo or human body too. In our opinion, polar body is in the zona area, and this is zona placidum. This is an area around the embryo before implantation. Polar body after transformation to PVS in the zona area between zona placida and embryo can control all the process of embryonic development and growth, like morula formation, cell cleavage, cell differentiation, and cavitation. All of them are in the zona placida. In this picture, you can see the ICM or inner cell mass and also imaginary PVS and zona placida. After hatching, the rest is embryo and PVS. And after implantation, the embryo plus ICM plus PVS implant into the uterus cell wall. During gastrulation, if you know about the embryologic viewpoint of a human body, during gastrulation, the PVS as an extra embryonic tissue can ingress into the embryo and can distribute among the mesodermal layer. Here is an embryo, chorion, exocoelom, yolk sac, amnion, amniotic sac, and intracoelom. You can see this section in this rectangle, that there is an embryo with mesoderm, endoderm, and ectoderm. In this picture, we are presenting the details of embryo, like mesodermal layer, which is the origin of internal organ, aorta, endoderm, and ectoderm. Mesoderm will be split into two layers. One is somatic mesoderm, and the other one is splanchnic mesoderm. Between them, there is a space called coelom. We believe that coelom is the origin of San Jiao in human body. In our theory, PVS is inside the coelom as a yellow color. And because the mesoderm is the origin of internal organ, around each organ, PVS can be enveloped every organ, like liver, spleen, heart, and etc. During invagination process, that each organ, this is mesoderm, each organ during invagination process can invaginate into the mesoderm, and finally we will have established organ like, for example, lung. Lung and mesoderm, this is parietal, and this is visceral. For example, this is parietal pleura, and this is visceral pleura. Between them, there is a space in chest. In the animal study, PVS just can be stained by a specific staining named trypan blue. Otherwise, PVS is invisible in human body, And just after staining with trypan blue, it can be seen like a network of blue distributed in the connective tissue, and it has a loose attachment to every organ. PVS is distributed in connective tissue like capsule, like adventitia, like serosa, peritoneum, pleura, and every other cavity that you can see in human body. Our second article has been published, the infrastructure of integrative human body, qi movement, and zheng. The synonymous of these words in ITM or traditional medicine is qi as dame, qi movement as ruh, and zheng as mezaj. It has been published in the same journal of International Integrative Medicine. In this article, we presented our second part of our idea as a fasciology, as a basic hypothesis in traditional medicine. Fasciology or fascia are the same as connective tissue around every organ, like liver, like intestine, like heart, spleen, even muscles and any other organs that you can imagine in human body. We believe that meridian and acupuncture points are distributed in this fascia. Some of them are in superficial layer and some of them is in deeper layer. And because the mesoderm is the origin of fascia, and also PVS was distributed among the mesoderm, so we believe that PVS is the origin of acupuncture system, meridian, and acupuncture point. Fascia, in other words, fascia is as a supporting structure for every organ because it is a connective tissue. Provide organs connection between liver and intestine. Provide communication between outside and inside of organ as a framework of liver and as a capsule of liver. Outside and inside of every organ can be connected by fascia, originated from the mesoderm, and it is as a supportive storage system, includes stem cells and connective tissue. Let me pass this slide because the discussion about this is maybe boring for you. This article is publishing in near future in this journal with this link. You can follow it in this journal and you can know about the detail of it. Now let me present some case presentation with signs and symptoms, then diagnosis, and then point selection, and then explanation about the reason for point selection. I invite Mahtab to present the case, and I will about the diagnosis and point selection.
A patient is referred to our clinic who is suffering from alternating bradycardia, tachycardia, palpitation, and shortness of breath. In physical examination, he has pale complexion, cold and dryness of skin, especially in hand, sweaty in face, hand and upper part of body, edema and a purple and light blue color in nails. In his past history, there is endogenous depression, slightly, anxiety, mental fatigue, mental exhaustion, sleep problems, sleeping not improved with sleep, and poor concentration. So what is your diagnosis?
As you can see in this case presentation and signs and symptoms, there is a lot of signs and symptoms that many of them are not related to each other. This patient had a mental symptoms, and also some of the sinus symptoms are about the skin, are about the lying, and are about the respiration. The diagnosis of this patient is heart qi deficiency leading to lung qi deficiency. The heart is the, as you know, the heart is origin of energy in upper burner, I mean the upper part or chest. I must explain for everybody that didn't or doesn't work in the acupuncture field. Upper burner and also the source of power in vascular system. So the qi or heart ability for movement of blood in the vascular is low, and blood has a stasis in the vein like lung and liver and also in lower limbs. So there is shortness of breath, cyanosis, edema, and blue color of skin and nail. In other sides, because there are not nourishing of brain by blood, so there is some mental sign and symptoms like depression or anxiety, a sleep problem, and poor concentration. What is your point selection for this patient? It seems that the best points that can help this patient is heart 5, pair 6, UB 15, REN 17, and REN 6. Among them, REN 6 is the front move point of San Jiao and Huang. San Jiao, in a previous slide, I explained it, that is a origin of all cavities in body. So every cavity can be linked or can be connected to San Jiao. And front move point is a tonification point for San Jiao. By tonification, REN 6, we can tonify every small cavity that there is around the San Jiao. This is one point, and the other point can be related to heart meridian and upper burner. I prepared 6 cases, but I would like to know that I can present 6 cases or I finish them. Present. I'm thinking about the boring of my workshop. I wouldn't like to be boring. Would you like to continue the case presentation, or I can go to next step?
I think you can present 1 or 2 cases.
3 cases, 2 or 3 cases.
2 or 3 cases would be enough. That would be good examples.
Okay. So, we continue the case presentation.
The problem of this case is spontaneous sweating, feeling of cold. He also complained of chronic cough worsened by excretion, scanty phlegm, difficult to expect, SOB, and oppression of the chest. He has a weak voice during interview. What's your diagnosis?
In this case, there's a concept in TCM that the wei qi or defensive qi is circulating under the skin. It is responsible for control of pore of skin, like sweating and like warming the skin. So in other side, lung is responsible for tonicity of voice. In this space, we have two major signs and symptoms. One, weak voice, and the other one, spontaneous sweating. Based on these two major signs and symptoms, the diagnosis is lung qi deficiency with phlegm. The lung is in the upper burner, or chest, I mean, and it is responsible for qi descending and distribution of qi under the skin as wei qi. It's responsible for opening and closing of pore of the skin, for sweating or dry skin. The spontaneous sweating and cold hand is due to wei qi deficiency resulting from lung qi deficiency. Because the lung circulates the qi in the chest and lung, the lung qi deficiency leads to chronic cough worsening by exertion. scant flame and difficult to expectorate it. Sorry, it is a wrong word. The SOB, shortness of breath, and oppression feeling in the chest may be due to not descending like lung qi, and so a kind of lung qi stagnation in the chest. In other side, lung control the voice, and so lung qi deficiency leads to weak voice too. What is your point selection for this patient in syndrome differentiation?
Excuse me.
Sorry? Yes, you have right, but I must explain this issue that in five element or circulation of five element in TCM, spleen is the mother of lung. Okay, and so when a spleen is deficiency, the lung is deficiency. Yeah, yes, you have right, because you are meaning that when a spleen qi deficiency, spontaneously or automatically will lead to lung qi deficiency. In this case, maybe these patients have the origin of spleen qi deficiency too, but may have not. It can be single, it can be alone, lung qi deficiency plus or minus spleen qi deficiency. No? Sorry.
I've seen this kind of case. That is because the heart is too strong.
You mean that this case, you have any other diagnosis for this patient?
I'm not in a medical area.
Oh.
But due to my cell practice, mm-hmm. I know that if the heart, okay, heart is the fire, and it's too strong, then it dominates.
No. You can see here, this patient has a spontaneous sweating. It is a major problem. It is a significant sign and symptoms for lung qi deficiency. When we have a spontaneous sweating and also SOB and also weak voice, this normally present the lung qi deficiency, not heart. Yes?
I didn't want you to interrupt. I was
no problem.
My question for final, but spontaneous breathing, very superficial breathing, the feelings of cold, also the Yankee, and what you said is definitely a Yankee deficiency. But as you know, by the Americans, from spin 20 to lung 1, that ascendance of that pure key. I agree with the doctor that perhaps have the swollen patient that the swollenness, perhaps it's due to a first spleen weakness previously. You know?
Yes, I agree. Because I said that the spleen is the mother of lung, and spleen is son of heart. So all of them are dependent in the circular of five elements.
The chronobiology from postnatal key and neural key.
Yes.
Is from spleen that
yes.
Goes up to lung.
So surely.
I agree.
Surely. We have a famous sentence in Iranian traditional medicine that the stomach is mother of all diseases. I mean, stomach and spleen is mother of all diseases.
And
it is the same meaning in the TCM too.
I agree with you. It's not only within young conditions. You can not only a one diagnosis. I agree with you also.
Yes.
Of course.
Yes. It is a suggestion.
Of course.
It is not definitively.
Absolutely. It's not more complicated for yes. something more.
In this case, I select line 9 because it is the yuan source point of the lying meridian, and it is connected to San Jiao. So it can tonify the lying qi and circulate the lying qi as a wei qi and the rest qi.
A master of vessels also.
Sorry?
Master of vessels.
Yes.
Also.
Yes.
Yes.
And the other point can be ST36, REN12, ST40, REN70, and UB30. Continue for case.
The next case is about a 46 years old woman complaining from feeling of a lump in the throat, difficulty of swallowing, chest oppression, chest distension, slight breathlessness. She also had sighing, sadness, slight anxiety, and depression. What's your diagnosis?
What is this lamp?
Lamp, it is a fling of a stone in
lamp.
Your throat.
It says it's a lump.
Mistake.
Are you
an
MP?
Oh, yes.
MP.
Yes.
Characteristic of phlegm, no?
Yes. Yes, it is LUMP. Sorry. Not swelling, not real swelling. A fling of swelling, a fling of foreign body in your throat. It is like globus hystericus in Western medicine. Anybody can
yes, globus
that?
Globus hystericus.
Globus hystericus. It is the same lump sensation in groove. Yes. This case is lung qi stagnation. The previous case was lung qi deficiency, but it is, he is involved to lung qi stagnation. The accompanying signs symptoms, such as the mental status and parachest symptoms, are showing the involvement behind the chest, such as the heart and or liver and kidney are involved too. Chest oppression and chest distension fling and a slight breathlessness is indicating the chest involvement. Fling of lump, here is correct.
And also the chest, no?
Yes. Difficulty of swallowing are indicating to involvement the parachest tissue. Sighing, sadness, slight anxiety, and depression are the heart grandmother of lying and or liver grandson of lying involvement and for mind-body disorder. The main points are line 7, ST40, REN15, and P6. As you know, line 7 is a opening point for REN MAI as an extra channel, and extra channel are connected to San Jiao space, not San Jiao meridian. They are different meaning, or they have different meaning. And the case, sorry, I'm worried about time. I stopped the case presentation because we don't have enough time, but there is some other case that I have prepared for you. Here, we present the San Jiao as a real space in body. It is originated from mesoderm layer in embryologic period, and by extension and organogenesis, that every organ in body is originated from mesoderm layer. So every organ like liver, spleen, heart, muscle, intestine, and etc. can be connected to that space that I called coelom. So San Jiao or coelom divided into thousands and thousands of cavity in body and is the source of all body and is connecting all bodies, all cavities of body to each other. So when we use the points that are related to San Jiao, we can tonify the qi, because as you know, everybody who work in acupuncture, San Jiao is the avenue of qi. So when we tonify qi, qi of San Jiao, we tonify qi of all body. And in brief, I can present the section of my book. If you would like, you can have me more explanation about my book. And here, Mahtab invites that to explain a little, about 2 to 3 minutes about our books. Thank you very much.
The first chapter of this book is, does primovascular system originate from polar body, PVS instead of stem cells as the ruler for fetal development hypothesis? In this chapter regarding previous findings based on introducing a new system, PVS, and the theory of PVS in the human body, we talk about PVS embryology. Based on this system, PVS is originated from the polar body, which according to the latest studies, polar body has an unknown role in human body. By using the similar roles of PVS in other beings and according to scientific evidence and hypotheses, we concluded that polar body is the origin of PVS in human embryo. To access a section of this theory, please refer to the article in Journal of Integrative Medicine International in the link below. In addition, the complete details of this theory will be published in our book soon. The second chapter is fasciology as 10th system of human body, Iranian traditional medicine and traditional Chinese medicine viewpoints. This chapter introduces connective tissue as fascia in the human body, which originates from mesoderm layers. Regarding the relationship between embryo mesoderm layer and formation of intracellular cavity and also connective tissue, the content of embryology and histology of San Jiao space is explained completely in this chapter. Chapter 3 is about Meraque or Triple Energizer San Jiao, actual or virtual organ, a hypothetical viewpoint. Based on embryology findings in Chapter 1 and scientific evidence about histology in previous chapters, this chapter introduced the real space of San Jiao, which according to this, with schematic, all its aspects will be shown with the schematic pictures. Chapter 4 is 10 aspects of San Jiao, triple burner or Meral. In this chapter, 10 aspects of San Jiao space, which are mentioned in traditional Chinese medicine books, have been introduced according to scientific evidence in previous chapters. It explains the difference in two schools in TCM called Nanjing and Neijing, which in the end, they concluded that from old time, Nanjing school believed San Jiao has a name but no form, and Neijing school rejects this idea. We are honored to explain this idea in depth for the first time in the history of TCM and explain that San Jiao is a real space. The last chapter is tracing of San Jiao and Galas vessels in TCM and ITM. After suggestion of existence of San Jiao as a real space in TCM and regarding our study in ITM, which has talked about a space or theoretical pathway called Galas vessel, this chapter will consider a comparison and similarization of mentioned vessel in ITM in San Jiao space and TCM meridian pathways. And in the end, we conclude that Galas vessels have 100% similarity with traditional medicine meridians, but this similarity includes some parts of main channels, divert channels, and collateral channels. In contrast with the idea that Galas vessels are similar to some current existing channels in TCM, this book will visualize the Galas vessels pathways for the first time in ITM history. Last but certainly not least, The writers are honored to announce that the book will be available soon for whom are interested. Thank you.
At the end, I thank you for your attention. Because this section is about the hijamat section for everybody who work in the hijamat. The qalaz vessel can explain the mechanism of hijamat, because hijamat in ITM or traditional medicine overall is a kind of treatment or therapy that treatment a disease that is other side or distance from the place of hijamat. So I mean that the qalaz vessel can explain very good about the transmitted diseases that is the mechanism, basic mechanism for hijamat.
Thank you very much for your exposition. It's very, very interesting your comparison with your own knowledge of your Meraque and qalaz vessel theory. It's very nice. Perhaps you heard my speech yesterday about the fascia. Well, I am very glad that we're not so wrong about the fascia function as our internal net that can explain local and distance effects of acupuncture through the needle. But remember, Chinese described San Jiao as the yang kidney function as functions. They didn't talk about the suprarenals and about thyroid. Thyroid.
Oh, yes.
They didn't describe as an organ.
Yes.
Thyroid, as triple warmer.
Yes.
And the yang function of the kidney. They didn't make any allusion to suprarenal glands. But they are. Perhaps it's another point of view of having another explanation, like a gland that have really general effects like the thyroid. That's one of my theories also. And it would be very interesting to share our knowledge.
Yes, surely. Surely, you are right. You are completely right. Because I didn't have enough time to explain my theory. But San Jiao is originated from the area between kidney, so it is connected to kidney. And also, San Jiao is original for thousands of cavity. One of them is thyroid. So kidney is related to thyroid. Exactly.
Yes.
Yes.
Thank you very much.
You are welcome.